This is a time that men call the unusual. Some fraction of them call it the impossible. Well, what's the unusual and what's the impossible? Yeah, that's us. Pretty much all of us. Because we are one and the same.
Agnes, go straight to the point.
Oh, sorry. This is a time the voice of a woman strikes fear in the hearts of men. This is a time a woman no longer withstands the push but are now the ones pushing. This is a time where reality has been broken up into fragments of our own reality. The reality we've all yearned for. This is a time
it's
where-
It's okay!
Wait, Cynthia and Tego standing you.
Hey girls, come on. Atokpe, don't bail out on me now. This is my world. The world I live in. And to be honest, now we get this. Well, it's no news how I've conquered the men. There's a worldwide equality on both sexes.
Oh, I do know some who identify as trans, bi and all those kind of stuff.
Don't confuse gender or sexual preferences with biological constructs.
Thank you, Dr. Clara, for that clarification.
You are welcome, but that was also at you.
Really?
Yes.
Well, back to what I wanted to say. The US and some of those countries have 100% equality. But here in Nigeria, I'll give it 80.
90?
Why 90?
Why 80?
Well, you must be wondering how we all got here. There's always a backstory. So let's rewind.
We'll be going to the mall next tomorrow, not tomorrow.
I already told you now, we're busy. Let's leave it tomorrow.
I'll be busy tomorrow.
Yes, sir, I'll be busy next tomorrow. So let's just leave it tomorrow.
But next tomorrow is Sunday.
I want to make my hair. Oh yeah, see what we'll do. Just send me the money, let me use and go out tomorrow. And on Sunday, all of us will go out.
No problems, I'll do that.
Daddy, guess what?
Hey, Dad.
Please, let me hear from you, my boy.
We have seen and confirmed our jam score, Dad.
And?
We made the cutoff mark, Dad.
So what was it?
Oh,
258, Dad.
Bravo! That's my boy!
Well, no.
That's my boy.
My doctor told your score, Jerry.
Please! Let's not spoil Ruben's score with disappointment.
Daddy Ruben, relax. She's your doctor.
Can anything good come out of Nazareth?
Dokwe, what was your score?
350.
You did good. Congrats.
Impossible! Impossible! Let me see the split out. Let me see the print out. Ah.
Can't you see? Is our name?
I cannot be fooled.
Fooled where?
She must have bribed her way out for this jam school.
Daddy Ruben.
Look at this.
Where do you think she'll get the money from?
Look at it.
No. But where do you think she'll get the money from? You pay her bills.
Please take this rubbish and get
that. That's okay, Mom. I've tried to please you, Dad, all these years. Yes, Ruben is your son. And definitely is going to bear your name forever. But don't forget, I'm also bearing your name.
And that currently.
I've never for once bullied Ruben, even if I'm the first. But yet you make me feel alien and neglected. You know, people tend to value their first. But yeah, I'm stuck with a father who does not even value me for being the first.
No. Let her speak. This is how she will go about talking in her husband's house.
Mr. Kola de Damilola. You've hurt me too deeply. Wow. And you know it. There's no need letting the cat out. I've paid enough from you, Dad. Yes. I can talk the way I want in my husband's house. And I pray you're not alive to witness it.
Ah! Oh,
yeah. Look at your daughter.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Look at your daughter.
Yeah.
Why is your face like that? Well, since you're not talking, no wahala. All I know is that I did not marry a deaf and dumb.
But you married me as your wife, your companion, for Christ's sake, your helpmate.
What's the grievance this time around?
The business, of course.
Oh, that.
Come now, don't take this like one of those discussions.
The business? What's there to discuss about the business? What's there?
Business, for crying out loud, is a family business. Our family business. And I do have a percentage of that business.
And I gave you that percentage. So on what grounds now?
I have business flourishing ideas. Rather than just share profits and bear loss. Trust me on this, I can deliver.
Babies! You can deliver babies, and I'm planning on a third one in order.
No, now, don't divert. Do you mean you can't talk business with your wife or what?
Look, sweetie, you can talk business. It's just that everyone is strong somewhere, yes, and weak elsewhere. And I think just leave the business aspect for us.
So you mean I can't talk business?
No, you can talk business. But we are not just equal there.
So the strangers are in our own family business.
Just remember that everyone is strong somewhere and weak elsewhere. Good night.
Agnes. Hello?
Well, Bobby, Mama will sell come off for you. What in the soft now? Where would the match enter now? Wait. See you chop pins. Move.
You don't know the matter there.
Hey, there's a match there. Who goes? Give me that phone. Bobby, bam. You don't get guard, Gabby. Yeah, what's it? Match that phone.
Match him.
Enough! And who the hell do you think you are? I'm a woman just like you. You know the difference is I'm way more richer. You know it!
Why 90?
Why 80? I asked you first. Agnes starts with the letter A, so you answer first.
Well, Chizzy starts with the letter... Oh, shit. Wait for what, Jerry?
Please, don't be you and just answer the lady.
Don't be you and just answer the lady.
Excuse me, are you talking to me?
Of course I'm talking to you.
I am your boss.
Boss? It is all my idea. I am the brain behind this network.
And I am the money.
Wait. Come to think of it. How come you girls never shared more details about yourself?
Well, if you must know, I am the brain behind this. A lecturer in a university. PhD to the name, Dr. Clara. But the system troubles on me too much with all this favoritism and politicking.
I obviously don't have to say much. My money speaks for itself. I finance this network. And ever since money touched someone's idea, we've been making progress. This brings me back to why I feel like, with so much equality now visible in the world, equality in our country is 80 to 90%.
Yes.
The answer is simple. Benga.
Who is Benga?
Our final foe. He's not only in opposition to the cause of gender inequality, he is the opposition. He takes young girls and holds them captives at the place he calls the forest. I say we bring the fight to him. We take out Benga, and at last, the song of gender inequality dies out forever. Are you even listening?
Hello? I'm too big for all this discussion. Let's kill this Benga guy already.
Calm down, hotshot. He's heavily guarded by two deadly men.
Men? Piece of cake.
That's not all. Getting past this man will need to handle the escort.
So, it's in his next up, right? Well, that's fine by me. Experience speaks for itself. Back to the plan.
The male guy.
Wait. I have a better idea.
What if we go out here and seduce them? I don't have the looks, right?
Please don't sweat it. You're someone's mom.
Jeez, why are you so hard?
Tope, please tell her.
My dear, we need not use our bodies to earn a point. Uh-huh. Or even earning a point with men. You know, we've got the brains too.
Yes. So, let's go.
Achieving this. Okay. You can see her dying to it.
I told you, Tope, bringing her in on this was a bad idea. She's only winning our chances.
Please, we've got girls to save in there, okay?
That's pretty much all of them, sir.
I like this one. And if I like this one, the client will surely like her the same or even more.
Everyone trembles at the mention of your name. And with the knowledge of you as a captor, no one will come against you.
Because they will perish. And that will be the last of their bloodline. But in the meantime, Evelyn, you have done well.
And even more, sir.
I'm listening.
I'm chasing another contingent. And I guess, more girls, more money.
Sure. And we will keep it that way. We have company.
I'll get a squad on it, sir. There's
something wrong there. There's something wrong there. There's something wrong
there. No.
Let me. Can you just let her be?
Oh, shit! Well, since this is a girl-to-girl situation, there'll be no need for this. Let's do this the old-fashioned way.
Wait, think of it. There's no need for all this. We're all fighting for
shut women. Shut up and let me.
Hey! that's nice.
I will take that as a thank you. You are welcome. Agnes, go for the girls. Watch out!
Hey.
I said watch out! I have other issues!
You monster!
We are all monsters without man. And man is hell without booze.
No! Without a woman, there is no man!
You talk too much, my friend.
That's because I want to make you talk less. Gender equality must strive in this country, and that's gonna be you out of the way.
This isn't America.
But we share one heritage, and that's humanity. 100% women, 100% men.
You seriously think you can defeat me?
Damn it, I forgot. By the way, we subdued your Eve squad the same way the devil did with an apple.
Impressive, I must say. Not too bad. You died this night.
Wait, you had the knife all this while, and you couldn't even kill somebody or set yourself free.
I've been waiting for the right moment.
Oh my God, I'm so sorry, sir. I'm so sorry.
Well, I've told you what to do. You are not the first, and you won't be the last. Yes, you are intelligent and perfect for the promotion.
Yes, sir.
But the thing standing between you and your demand is... Make a stand. Oil it up with your cream. You know the cream we had as lubricant for the process. So what will it be, Haggy?
Please, sir. Please. I have an old mother. A younger sister to train. A stranded elder sister with two children. And a cheesy to pay off. I beg of you, sir.
I've told you what to do. Just make love with me. You will get your pending salary and the promotion, like I said.
I'm sorry, sir, I can't. There must be another way.
Get out of my office! Get out of my office! That's the only other way.
Then I guess I'm sending this to the headquarters.
What's that?
Everything you have said in here. A dare will tell if I'm joking or not. One tap. And it's on the platform. And you sure know what that means, right?
Okay, okay. I will do it. Good. There you go. Your astounding salary and the promotion, it's wholesale.
Well, thank you, sir. But I must. Why are men like you so wicked and also very stupid? I mean, very stupid. Well, I do have a good voice though. Well, all this doesn't matter anymore. Because in my world, you have long been defeated.
Okay, right about now, this is BTS. We are arguing if we will need car in this scene or not. I'll be Adam. Father's got enough feeding. Holy Father, my Holy Father. Holy Father, Holy Father, screaming my lady God.
Okoro Amarachi. This is day one shoot of AGGY'S World. So literally AGGY, Agnes. And I play a very, very unique character because in the play I have two worlds I live in. My imagination, where in one I was the most untouchable woman on earth with a lot of money, influence, power. And then in the normal world, I was just a nobody searching for a job with a pervert. So it's a really nice movie and I feel the outcome is going to be massive because putting a lot of work already. And yeah, you guys should just watch out. Let me not spill everything now so that when you watch it, you're going to enjoy it.
The love Chizerum, playing the role of Cheesy in AGGY'S World. Yeah, Cheesy is a hot shot. She loves action. There's nothing challenging about the role though. You get, yeah. It's more like normal daily life and all that.
I can't face it all alone. This shit is detrimental to my body and my soul.
So today, we shot the fight scene. Omo, you need to see me the way I was shooting them one by one. Taking them one by one.
Sarah.
Watch out for AGGY'S World Part 2.
Cold TV.